Alright, hey guys, so today I'll be taking a quick look at a game called Cult Express. This is a strategy board game, and it was based on a real board game, which I can show you guys really fast. So here is the real board game. It actually looks pretty interesting. You play as a bunch of bandits, and you're trying to rob a train car, and you compete against each other. Whoever has the most money at the end wins the game. So let me go back to the game on Steam, and we're gonna try it out. I'm not like the biggest fan of board games just because they are very RNG based, but we'll try this out and see if we can have any fun. We're gonna play the tutorial to begin with. I played the tutorial already, but I just wanted to show you guys because it's actually quite a complicated game to learn. But once you learn the mechanics, it's actually pretty interesting. Alright, so we jumped on the train. To win, you must collect more loot than the other bandits. The game ends after 5 rounds. Each round is made up of 2 phases, scheming and stealing. For the tutorial, you'll be playing as Tuco. These are your cards. You get 6 cards from your deck. Each card represents a specific action. Each round is a series of turns. The goal of the game is to get the most loot. Play a robbery card to grab some loot by dragging it from your hand to the field. So we're playing a robbery card. He's playing a move card, and he's playing a shoot card. With the scheming phase complete, we now carry on the actions that we have been previously programmed. Alright, so I'm going to steal this gem. That'll get me $500. So he played a moved card, which allows him to move across the train cars. And then Doc played a fire card. And he's using one of his 6 bullets. And I got hit. Ouch. Doc's bullet card is added to your deck. Round 2, we'll play 2 turns. Each round, the next bandit in line becomes the first player. A marker is shown on the portrait of the first player of the round, in this case, how do you pronounce that? Diego? Something like that. Bad luck, you drew Doc's bullet card from the last round. This is a dead card. Okay, so dead cards, I don't think they do anything. So we're going to be playing a punch card. Punch cards allow you to punch another bandit, and it allows you to make them drop some loot, and it also pushes them to another train car. So we're also playing a fire car, which will allow us to shoot another bandit, and that will give them a dead card in their hand. At the end of the game, whoever shoots the most earns a $1,000 bonus. So it's actually pretty good to start shooting early on. So we're gonna punch this guy, make him drop the loot, and send him to the other train car. Floor change, yep. Diego played a marshal card. The marshal moves 1 car in either direction and never goes on the roof. So here's the marshal. You can attack the marshal, but if you're in the same car as the marshal, he will shoot you and he'll send you to the roof. Your turn to play, we're gonna shoot this guy. Round 3, a new strong box appears in the car where the marshal is. The marshal is next to an opponent. Play a marshal card. So we play the marshal card. The marshal card lets us move the marshal 1 space to the left or to the right. If you do not like your cards, you can draw 3 cards. Then we're gonna fire. When the marshal shares a card with the bandit receives a neutral bullet card. This forces the fleet to the roof. Okay. So we're moving the marshal from here to here, and that will get him shot and move to the roof. Diego's turn. He shot the dock. And then the marshal just shot me. Skip your turn, because I drew 3 cards that turn. Pretty cool seeing a board game being brought to life in a video game. I think that's pretty cool. Although I kind of said that wrong. It's kind of cool that a board game can be represented in a video game like this. It looks really cool. Anyways, fire at Diego. Okay, so we're gonna fire at this guy. Take all. Alright, round 4 is special turns, tunnels, speeding up, and switching. So, certain turns, there's different things that happen. So I'll show you in a second. So we're going to move. So when we enter the tunnel, we don't get to see what other players are playing. Everyone has to play their cards face down. So it's kind of like a mystery round. You're not really sure what's going to happen. And then speeding up round, you get to play two cards at once. And this is the tutorial, so it's kind of telling me what to do. That's why I'm not doing any strategy or anything like that. So play a robbery card. There we go. This is round four. There's just one more round after this. Your turn to play. We'll move over here. So Tuco can actually shoot through the roofs of train cars. He has a special ability that allows him to do that. And Doc just picked up a briefcase. The briefcases have $1,000 in them, so they are the most valuable. The gems have $500, and the sacks have between $200 and $500. So I'm going to shoot this guy through the roof. Bam. Climb down. And we're gonna punch the doc, make him drop the briefcase, and we'll send him to the marshal, and that'll get him shot and sent to the roof. So that was kind of like a combo move there. He just punched at nothing because there was no one in that car. And he just got shot again. As you saw, Dango punching the air and Doc climbing on the marshal, planning is difficult and can lead to chaotic and undesirable but still fun situations. I really wish I would have played the board game. I think it would have been more fun if I already had experience with the board game. So if you're fans of the board game, you're really going to enjoy this, because it's almost identical to the board game, I believe. So we're going to pick up the briefcase, get us an extra $1,000. And he just shot at nothing. And he also did nothing. Oops, accidentally hit my mic, sorry about that. Round 5 is the last round of the game. The tutorial is done. You can exit to the main menu or you can finish the game. So let's finish the game. There's one more round. Each bandit who's either in the locomotive or on its roof gets $250 ransom. Cool. So if you get to the locomotive, you get an extra $250 if you're at the locomotive at the end of the game. Okay, so what do we have here? We don't have a whole lot we can do. We can steal a gem. I guess we'll... I guess we'll steal a gem. And then on this round, I think... Let's see. I think I'm gonna draw three cards. We got a gun. And then on this round, when we're in the tunnel, I'm gonna shoot. And on the final round, I'm going to move to the locomotive to get an extra $250. There we go. So the AI is kind of stupid. I don't know why they moved the marshal to the caboose. They should have moved it towards me, and then it would have kicked me out. Oh well. Pick up a gem. It's an extra $500. Alright, now I'm gonna shoot the doc. Oh, he's punching me. Ah, no! And he made me drop the briefcase. Damn it. I'm gonna shoot this guy now. Alright, so unfortunately, I won't get the $250 bonus because I'm too far away. If you're on the ceiling, on the roofs of the cars, and you play a movement card, you can actually move, I think, 2 to 3 spaces at once instead of just one. So unfortunately, I didn't get the $250 bonus, but that's okay because I'm going to get the Gunslinger bonus, which gives me a $1,000 bonus for shooting the most players. And as you can see, I was in second, but it put me in first after the bonus. Okay, so now we're going to play a real game, and in the actual game, I'm going to be strategizing a little bit more. There is a story mode too, which is just full of a bunch of challenges and some story elements with each character. So it's kind of cool that there's like an entire campaign to the game, even though it's very, very RNG based. Let's go do a quick play. This game does have multiplayer. You can play online with friends, which is great, and I think you can play locally as well. Let's play as Tuco again, just because I know his special ability. You can shoot at the bandit who's on the same car as him on the other level and through the roof of the car. Okay. Pretty fun little board game. I mean, it's enjoyable. It would definitely be enjoyable with friends. Playing with, like, other people, not just AI. Playing against, like, robots with board games doesn't fit well with me, but oh well. Swivel arm, all the bandits that are on the roofs move to the roof of the caboose. Alright. Alright, she played a move card. So let's see. I think I'm gonna steal some money to begin with. Because there's a bunch of money below me. Oh wait, there's just one. Oh well. There's one. I thought I was in the caboose, but I'm actually in this middle car here. My turn to play? Alright, I think I'll shoot someone. And then on third round, I think I'm just going to draw three cards. Because all I have is movement cards, and movement cards, in my opinion, are kind of worthless. For the most part, at least at the beginning of the game. So the girl moved. My turn, I'm going to steal this loot. Got me $500, I think, or $400. I think it got me $400. And she just punched me to the... She made me drop my loot. That sucks. So now I'm down to $400. Okay, my turn. I get to shoot the girl. Pow. So currently I'm in the lead for the gunslinging bonus. Basically, whoever ends the game with the least amount of bullets gets the $1,000 gunslinger bonus. So that's what I'm going to be aiming for, because Tuco's special ability is shooting through cars. And now I just got shot, so now I'm tied with the girl. And that girl climbed up to the ceiling. Swivel arm. Alright, a new strongbox appears in the car where the marshal is. So the marshal's in the, I forgot what do you even call that? In the, first car. I forgot, what's the first car of a train called? The conductor car? I don't know. Whatever. Okay, so round two, I'm gonna go ahead and steal that gem on the ground. I think I went first this round. Yep, I went first this round. My turn to play. I guess I'm going to shoot someone. Play your second card. My second card, I guess I will move up. Because there's a briefcase in the front car. So if we can get up to the front car and get that briefcase, we'll get $1,000. Alright, my turn. I guess I'll play a movement card, so I can get up to the front of the car and steal something. Alright, a new strongbox appears in the car where the marshal is. My turn to play, we're gonna steal the gem, $500. I got punched. Probably gonna take my gym. Damn, he took my gym. Now I'm back at $400. That's okay. I'm gonna shoot that guy. Screw him for taking my freaking gym. Every time you shoot someone, they get a dead card. I think that, like, limits the amount of cards they get on the next turn or something like that. I'm not entirely sure. So far, I think I'm in the lead, as long as I keep the Gunslinger bonus. I don't have the most money, but getting the $1,000 bonus is going to be very helpful. And it looks like you can't see the money that the other people have. You can just see their loot. So I guess you just have to guess, or just count it up, I guess. Okay, so what I'm going to do here is I'm going to move all the way to this car. She couldn't shoot anyone because there was no one in the car to the left or right of her. When you play a shoot card, there has to be someone to the left or right of you. Or if you're my character, you can shoot below. And I'm getting shot again, damn. Everyone's going after me. So there's two briefcases in this car. So I think that's going to be my objective, is to get to that car. But first, I need to move the conductor. Let me look at the other people's moves. Okay, so no one's moving the conductor currently. So everyone's moving. And I'm playing last, I believe. So I guess... I can shoot the dock. Let's go ahead and shoot the dock, because that's pretty much all we can do unless I wanted to climb down. I don't really want to climb down quite yet. So I'm just going to shoot another person. I could climb down and steal like a gym or something, but then they're probably going to move the marshal and get my butt kicked, so I'm not going to do that. Alright, so this is a double round, so you get to move twice. Is anyone playing a marshal card? Like, no one's playing the marshal cards. I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to draw three cards. And then I'm going to move. Round three, stealing. No, he's moving all the way to the back. Alright, so I'm gonna shoot the dock. Yeah, I'm definitely like far in the lead as far as the gunslinger bonus. We are on round three, so there's only two more rounds left. I have to keep that in mind. They can still win. Just because I get a $1,000 bonus doesn't mean I'm gonna win. The dock has a lot of money currently. Alright, so I'm gonna move to the front. This is where the briefcases are. Angry Marshal. All bandits on the roof of the car of the Marshal. Wait. All bandits on the roof of the car the Marshal is in get a neutral bullet card each. The Marshal moves one car towards the caboose. I think that happens at the end of the round. So here's my plan. I'm going to play the move the Marshal card. And then I'm going to climb down and steal the briefcases. And with any luck, I'll be able to keep at least one of those briefcases till the end of the game. So now I'm going to climb... Oh, wait. Shoot, someone else played the move the Marshal card too. Damn. Oh, he's going to screw me over. I guess I'll climb down and see what happens. I think one of the AIs knows what I'm doing, and they're going to try to counter me. This kind of sucks. Try to steal the briefcase, but it all depends on what the AI does. Oh, I got shot. Damn. So I'm moving the marshal over here, but the next turn, someone's gonna move the marshal again, and I feel like he's gonna move it towards the front again, and I'm gonna get screwed over. Oh, are you kidding me? Oh, crap. I got screwed. The rest of this round is just, it's pretty much over. I have to go down, and then I'm gonna get shot and sent back up. Oh, screw that. Everyone's, like, going for me. This is so unfair. I've been shot 3 times in this round. Damn. Crap. Yeah, that guy just completely screwed over my plan. I wasn't paying attention. I should have seen that he was gonna move the marshal. If I would have seen that, I could have prevented that. I just got shot freaking again. Okay, round 5. Each bandit who's either in the locomotive or on its roof receives sooner for the other ransom. That's what the front card's called, locomotive. I don't know why I forgot that. Okay, so he's playing the move the marshal card. He's gonna move it back over here. This is so freaking unfair. I'm gonna play the move the marshal card. And then I'm gonna climb down. Hopefully no one else has a marshal card. If I can steal just one freaking briefcase, I'll win the game for sure. Because no one else has a briefcase. So I played the climb down card, so now we're gonna play a steal card, get a briefcase. And in the last round, I guess I'll play a gun card. Actually, it might be better to play a move card. To get to the... No, let's just play a gun card. We'll see what happens. Might not be the best plan, but... Oh well. Oh my god. She was gonna foil my plan. Good thing I caught that. So I'm sending the marshal back to the second car. Then I'm gonna move down, steal that briefcase. Everyone's trying to get to the front car to get the $250 bonus. Alright, climbing down, gonna get the briefcase. So it looks like there's a 3-way tie for the gunslinger bonus. If I don't shoot someone on the last round, I might not get the bonus, which is gonna suck. Oh, that was lucky. He could have sent the marshal back at me and I would have been screwed. Yes. Briefcase, $1,000. Hooray! Oh, there's no one nearby though. Unless the doc decides to drop down, which I don't think is gonna happen. Miss. Your turn to play. Ah, crap, missed. It's a good thing I didn't play that move card. I think it would have forced me to move. Everyone else is missing. Hostage taking. Good game. I got $250 bonus for getting to the front of the car. And I think I'm in first place, money-wise. Let's see. Oh, I'm in second? I'm tied for... Yes! No! No, I had the same amount as... What? What? Hold on, I had the same amount of money. $2,650. So, why did he win the game if I had the same amount of money as he did? That doesn't make any sense. Shouldn't we have tied? I don't understand why... This doesn't make any sense to me. Well, I'm gonna just say that I came in first as well. It was a tie for first. For some reason, this game doesn't know that I had the same amount of money, which doesn't... I don't know. If anyone can explain that, if the developers see this video, can they explain why I came in second? Because I feel like I should have came in first. But that was a fun game. There's a lot of strategy involved. If you're a fan of strategy games, this game is pretty enjoyable. And it's definitely a good game to play with like friends and family for sure, or other people online multiplayer wise. A lot of RNG though. It's kind of hard to predict what the other players are going to do or where they're going to go or what's going to happen. You have to be very like diligent and like check what move each person does to make sure that you're not going to get screwed over by someone moving the marshal like I did. But yeah, really fun game. I think it's definitely something I would recommend if you're a fan of board games. I think it's a little bit too RNG based though. It's kind of like random what's going to happen, but there is some strategy to it, which I think is nice. And the graphics look great, the music's good, everything else is pretty awesome. It's really nice that it was actually based on an actual board game. I can just show you again really fast. This is what the board game looks like, so kind of cool that they kind of mimic the board game very closely. So yeah, that's all I have to say. If you guys want to check out this game on Steam, I'll leave a link to the store page in the description below. Thanks for watching, and have a nice day.